Hold on, it's Nicolas Cage and a pig, and it's not a comedy? There is no way. This is one of the biggest surprises of the year so far. What is up, Flick fans? Welcome back to my channel. This weekend, coming to theaters is a movie called Pig from the studio Neon, and I am so excited to talk about it. Nicolas Cage, what a year he has had thus far, and let's get right into it. So a truffle hunter who lives alone in the Oregonian, he's in Oregon, the wilderness, must return to his past in Portland in search of his beloved foraging pig after she is kidnapped. So I won't lie, this movie starts out and it's very reminiscent of John Wick. I'm like, it's Nicolas Cage's version of John Wick. So I'm expecting it to go in one direction after about the first 15 minutes. But the film does something entirely different than what I expected. And surprisingly, the best parts about this movie, even though I've already read off the premise and you expect it to be this ridiculously over-the-top film in the same vein of some of Cage's other movies this year, like Willy's Wonderland, or one that y'all are going to see that I saw at a film festival, and there's no way we were getting anything crazier than Prisoners of the Ghostland. So this movie is calm, subdued, emotional, and beautifully, and I mean beautifully, paced. Now, I feel as if some are going to feel the opposite when it comes to the pacing, because it does move very slowly, but I believe it's slowly and strategically to tell its story revolving around Cage's character that has been locked away in this cabin for such a long time, just he and his pig. Now, we slowly discover and uncover things about his past that point to the reason why, but when he arrives in this city with Alex Wolff's character, and we'll talk about that character here in just a second, we slowly begin to uncover his past, how much of an impact he has made on this town. And all of these things are uncovered in such a way that feels way more exciting than it actually should, just because of the route that we go. And other than one scene at the beginning that I don't know if it was as well fleshed out and explained as it needed to be, I feel like a lot of people will walk away going, well, what did that scene really mean? And why was it as integral as the film pointed it out to be? Other than that, as we get into some of these conversations and discussions, and a lot of it is about love and loss and that emotional bond that you can form with sometimes a human, sometimes a pig, how that can often carve a path in your life that allows you to feel emotions that you never imagined and allows you to really see things from a different perspective. And Austin, what are you talking about? I thought this was Nick Cage and a pig. I thought it was going to get crazy and riveting and exciting. Well, it is riveting, but it's riveting in a way that is much more subdued than anticipated. Now, it's not just Cage's Rob, right? There are more characters in this film. Adam Arkin plays a character by the name of Darius, and you'll know it when you meet him, but there are some things about that character that I was really happy that we explored. And then Alex Wolff, who plays Amir. And when we start out, I'm like, okay, how is this going to go? What role is he going to play? And how is this relationship going to form between he and Cage? But it was actually one of my favorite parts of the film. There are some things we learn about him, an unexpected element to his backstory that we slowly start to uncover. And all of these things move concurrently to the end of the film that culminates in just some of the best emotion I felt all year. Now again, I will say it's one of those movies that you have to kind of open up to, because after the first 10 minutes, I thought it was going one way. It went a completely unexpected and different route. And once I realized this wasn't going to be an action-packed thrill ride and Nicolas Cage was using his words and his wit as opposed to his fist and a gun, I really opened up to that idea, and once I allowed it to hit me in that way, man, I was locked in until the end of the film. And the final 1 to 2 minutes of this movie, the final scene, if you will, is just an emotional gut punch, and I loved every second of it. In terms of criticisms, I believe the movie is a bit too dark, and I mean visually at times. There were points where I couldn't entirely tell what was happening, but that was really only at the beginning of the film. And again, that one point in the first act that I just feel like wasn't fleshed out to its entirety, other than those few things, I was riveted by pretty much everything about this movie. And Nicolas Cage gives one of the best performances of the year. I'm not kidding. The range that this guy has, sometimes not the best, sometimes amazing. Well, this time, it's amazing. I think it's one of his best performances ever. One more thing, I don't want to spoil too much, but this movie also explores the culinary world, specifically in Portland, but that's an aspect of the film, and there's one conversation in particular. They're in a restaurant at a point in the film where Cage is speaking to one of the chefs, and that back and forth and just what he has to say and what he brings out of that character made me think, maybe even more so than any other conversation I've seen on screen this year. Just be on the lookout for that. I thought it was riveting dialogue. And the direction here from Michael Sarnowski is just outstanding. I believe this is his first feature film. Oh my goodness. So before I give you my score, if you guys enjoyed this review, be sure to drop your thumbs up down below and come back for many more this week. What will go down as one of the biggest surprises of the year, Pig manages to surpass expectations and provide a completely unexpected emotional gut punch. Cage may just give the best performance of the year. It is one of the best movies of the year. My score for Pig is 88%. This film just did so much. Completely unexpected. Again, you have to be on board with the way that it moves and just know it's a very calm movie, which is not what a lot of people are going to be expecting going into this film, but it is beautiful in that way. Man, I won't lie, I had some tears at the end. Maybe somebody was cutting onions. We'll never know. You guys the best. I'll see you soon.